And then all of a sudden he was 1 meter above, and then of course and that, you know what, most of you know what that means. It was the picture that Pim showed us. And after he went to the ceiling, so I mean, when we met by chance in a meeting like this at lunch, he started talking and he explained to me what happened to him. Okay, so he hadn't talked to anybody in 50 years about that. And since he heard about the discussion that we had with the physicist about quantum psyche, he dared talking to crazy people like Hirster what happened to him. That's how I happened to meet this man, and we became the best friends. Because I told him, you are at this level, you are in the etheric level, and then you are going to the astral level, and then you are going through the ceiling, and you are going through a fantastic journey that I will not explain, because it more or less resembles others, although it doesn't have a life review, this kind of thing. But he saw the light, he even saw, he saw and went in the Akashic record, and he was told that if he had the right level of consciousness, he could access anything which is inside. He tried to force the entry, but he was not high enough in consciousness. So, and then he had the light coming, and the light told him, okay, the blue line there is your world. And he said, I did not feel it. This was my world. I thought this was nothing, I knew. But the light then insisted that he should follow the light. And all of a sudden he was scared. And he asked to return. And he returned. I make it very short because it's a long story. So he ended up in the ceiling, and 1 meter above his bed, and back to his body. He entered his body. So this is a classical type of phenomenon. Now, the important thing and the good news is that the foreword of this book has been written upon his own will. He begged to have the honor to write the foreword. And this is Professor François Gros. And Professor François Gros is an honorary perpetual secretary of the Academy of Science of France. He's a biologist. And he is a notorious materialistic, the usual type. He is 90 years old. So, of course, we can forgive him all his past. Because at his epoch, when he was a young man, nobody knew about near-death experiences and stuff like that. But he was smart enough when he read, because those men are friends. So Jean-François sent him his text to have his opinion, and the guy said it changed my understanding of everything. So he wrote the preface. I don't know how much time I still have. I have about 10 minutes. I'm going to read you it's a short preface, by the way, but for decades, consciousness has been the object of intense debates amongst those striving to identify its nature through its manifestations of neurophysiological, metaphysical, or even religious origin. The psychology of the physician tried to define its limits, its quantification in extreme behavioral conditions potentially associated to certain pathologies, but also in some meditative states, dreams, or ecstasies of mystical inspiration. It's already this for a man of his stature and well known for being a materialistic man. Okay. Few, however, are the publications which, like the one of Jean-François Say, has extended the analysis of the diverse categories of consciousness to such a deep level. An attempt, all the more remarkable from the author, a known biologist, as attested by his numerous publications, that one might have expected to be reticent to explore a realm of thought somewhat distant from those who are proponents of life sciences typically occurred. This is very clear. I was surprised that his friend there going in those spooky areas, but he follows. This is the good news. As referred to in the early chapter of the book, which tells the intimate story that the reader is invited to discover, and I will not explain. It is through a personal, exceptional experiences that Jean-François Rousset found himself confronted to a series of peculiar and unexpected psychological situations, which eventually cast light on the plurality of expressions, but also meanings of various forms of consciousness. This first part of the book, indeed provides a description, striking by its precision, of out-of-body phenomena, this conscious split, this lucid waver of the earthly body that the author had to undergo a few decades ago, an experience which would deeply modify his vision of beings and things. Some would have made the choice to keep confidential this experience. Actually, he kept it confidential for 50 years. But under my gentle pressure, he spoke out, and then I invited him to come to a cycle of conferences that I was leading about science and spirituality, and the audience was so enthusiastic about what he said that I asked him to promise that he would write a book, and of course he was the star of the show, so he promised anything I asked. But after it took me one year and a half before he finished writing it. Of course, after we changed everything, and this has been published with Guy Trédaniel, which is the publisher of Ben Alexander, of Raymond Moody, of maybe Ruben Steven, Stefan, I mean, also you. Okay, Guy Trédaniel is the publisher of the people like us who are talking about the future. Okay, some would have made confidential. On the contrary, Jean-François Rousset, man of science, form of objectivity and wisdom, strives to benefit from it. He is led to examine and question the various states through which consciousness can manifest itself, their profound meaning with respect to human being and its origin, to its place in the physical universe, which results in this book of a rare analytical quality, a real exploration in the field of human brain. Okay, it goes on and on. I'm not going to go much further, but just give you an idea of the way he structured the consciousness reality. In order to better understand the nature of conscious states expressed outside the purely material context, and to some extent, waken into this man is internalized consciousness somewhat currently atrophied. Jean-François Rousset attempts to propose a more precise definition of the different levels of consciousness. It will serve as a benchmark throughout the book. Okay, there is a primary consciousness, type 1, which is the vital continuity of the physical body, which controls and regulates unconscious biological functions, which contribute to maintaining homeostasis of our physical body. Okay, then the ordinary reflective consciousness of type 2, the one which has at the outcome of the evaluation of our species, this I cannot explain why you say that, is the result of the cognitive ability of our brain, intelligence, analysis, and abstraction capabilities, plus memory. And finally, the so-called lucid reflective consciousness of type 3, the author proposes that it would only express itself in situations like OBE, NDE, certain other state of meditation and stuff like this, One could also accept it during so-called lucid dream, deep meditation, etc. Okay. We say this is the full expression of our being. And Professor François Gros now endorses that, you know, because he summarized very well the book, which is 200 pages, in 5 pages. Okay, John Robert, this model also strives to account for some of the great concern of a metaphysical nature, such as the concept of absolute individuation, fate, etc. This is indeed in us potential non-being side, not yet expressed, beside the primary conscious, see above, and definitely complex, our individuation, the two other types of consciousness, type 2 and 3, would have developed beyond the first one, which is the primary animal, I would say, type of consciousness. Then he explains in the long chapter about the Neanderthal and the Sapiens and all this thing with the right and left brain, and that the Neanderthal had a very developed the right side, that they disappear because of a catastrophe, and a very little of Neanderthals remains in our body. All of us are between 2 and 5% of Neanderthal, and altogether something like 30% is still living in the humanity. And, Sapiens won because it did not disappear. It was spread all over the planet, whereas Neanderthal was mostly in Europe. Sapiens has a left side much developed. I insist a little bit on that because this would explain, according to say, the fact that we are so materialistically oriented, whereas Neanderthal was very much loving, caring, and intuitive, and so on and so forth. Which is something that I leave to your expectations. If you are French speaking or reading, you can buy this book at the Très Daniel, and maybe one of these days we will do a translation into English. Okay, so at the end, he says the book ends with a remarkable fresco, which is where are depicted the great phases traversed by humanity, which I just did, tracing the evolution which led from the Australopithecus to Homo sapiens, to end up, as he says, to what we are at the present time, with our amazing technical know-how, with facing all the challenges specific to the modern era, demography, conflicts, climate of alliance, etc., and conclude with a vision of our future humanity, which is very close to yours. That's why I think it's interesting to see a bunch of old-fashioned scientists stating this kind of thing. Why are we calling what catastrophes? I lost the paragraph. I'm on the wrong one. Okay, two more paragraphs, and that's it. We call it what astrophysics suggests today as being the extreme limits of life on our planet Earth, and mentioning that mastery of new technologies would bring to humanity, the author claims the absolute necessity for the man of the future to get to know what he really is within the universe, not to become its master and owner, but to reach the true wisdom and accept what he names the superior realities. What you know, the new paradigm. May this appeal be followed in these times of turmoil and hope of all kinds, where humanity is torn between the serene scores of progress and discouragement caused by the loss of moral values, sometimes even barbarism, as we all know. Learn again what our true condition means, rediscover who we really are, would indeed mark the beginning of our return to a certain form of wisdom. Thank you very much.